Is Mama Lucia the picture start with the business, and she taught him how to drink the tea since she was little in the baby bottle. And he will share his knowledge with you. After his presentation, you will be certified tequiler, which means tequila expert, master degree.
Okay, amigos, Luis, thank you for coming. Everybody, welcome. My name is Luis, and I am the man in charge to be your rank today. Okay, one more thing.
This tequila is so good, so fine, you don't get drunk. You only get happy.
All right. So, amigos, to make tequila, we use this beautiful plant here. We call the blue agave plant. So in Mexico, we have about 100 varieties of agaves. Among those is the aloe vera, the same family. But the only one to make tequila, amigos, is blue agave. These plants here, younger than that, these are about 6 years old. That is about 8 years old. The plant must be at least 9 to 10 years to be ready to make tequila. So once you're ready, we have to cut the leaves, so we use only the center of the plant. As you can see, that center is bigger than this. That's one more years. So once there without the leaf, looks like a pineapple. So we call it agave pineapple. That agave pineapple, amigos, among other many components, that is full of sugar, starch, and yeast. So to get the juices out of it, we have to cook them in an oven in a very slow fire. Before we cook them, we have to cut it in half so in pieces. And to make 1 liter of tequila, we need about 2 of these agave pineapples. So let me show you over there inside. Let's go and see the oven and the rest. And this is the tool we use to cut the leaves. We go like this, we cut the leaves. Next, we cut it in pieces and we put it to cook on this oven. We call it by joke the Mexican microwave. Actually, amigos, it's a steam pot. We use gas fuel, that's the gas connection in the back. So we put 5 underneath, water first, then the agaves. And you can see it's clay on the outside, but metal in the middle. So we put that door here, very tight, and we leave it here to cook for 3 days and very low fire. Mm. After they are cooked, after 3 days, we leave them 2 or 3 more days to let them cool. So once they cool, we take them out, so we cut it in small pieces, because next we have to smash them. Let me show you the next step, amigos. This way, please. Okay? So we cut them here on this wood. Next, we put it on this skin just to smash them. So we go like this. We smash every single piece. Okay, so this fiber, this is the part of the plant we use to make the real artisanal tequila. When you shake a bottle of artisanal tequila, you can see the bubbles, or the pearls of the agave. Those pearls come from this part of the plant, the fiber. Commercial tequila, they don't use this. We use this. Now we are fermenting some. You like to take a look here. It's kind of a strong smell, but you can see. So we put water first, then the smashed agaves there. We leave them there for 10 days. So we let the mother nature to work for us. You know yeast, they are microbacteria that eats the sugar and the starch, and that becomes in tequila after fermentation and distillation. So once they are fermented for 10 days, we separate the fiber and the juices, amigos. The fiber, we use the fertilized agave fields and the juices we call must. That's the one we're going to use for distillation on the alambique on the next step. This is the alambique for distillation, amigos. By the moment, we are not distilling. We make tequila one time every month. The whole process is we get the fresh agaves until we get the tequila in that container takes 18 to 20 days. So this is the alambique. On the bar we put fire in this container. There is a stainless steel container inside. So we leave this. So we put the fermented juices in the hole you see in the middle. See, there's a hole in the middle. Then, when it starts to boil, that is 80 to 90 degrees Celsius, the steam comes all over this tube, and this tube is connected to this little faucet here. In this container, we have only just regular cold water. That cold water makes the steam becomes a liquid again to condense the steam. So that is the process of distillation. Most commercial tequilas, amigos, in Mexico, we have about 3,000 brands of tequila. They distill two times. Here in this company, Mama Lucia Company, we distill three times. And we are not the only one. There is a few more that makes the same. That makes the tequila more smooth, more pure, and better quality. So once we distill the three times, amigos, the first stage we got, we call that silver, blanco. And that is the one I recommend you, especially to make margaritas or any other mixed drinks. And that is the most requested by Mexicans, because we Mexicans, we like strong tequila. But you don't worry, you don't like too strong, we have añejo, aged tequila, the smoothest. But we also have some flavors, coffee, almond, vanilla, walnuts. So that blanco, we put that on barrels, American White Oak from Tennessee, for 3 to 11 months. And then we get the second stage we call reposado, rested. That has an amber color. The amber color comes from the wood, from the barrels. And that is the one I recommend you only for shots. Most people, amigos, you know about that. They drink the lemon salt. Lemon salt is a very old tradition in Mexico to mask the bad quality of tequila. Yeah. When it's 100% agave, we don't recommend you lemon salt because spoil the quality or spoil the flavor. Mm. So if I see somebody in Puerto Vallarta drinking tequila with lemon salt, that means two things. They don't know much about tequila, or they're drinking the cheapest tequila. Mm-hmm. And for the best tequila, the top shelf tequila, amigos, that's añejo, aged. We aged that on French oak barrels for 3 years. Most commercial tap tequilas, they age a year and a half, because remember, more than 1 year is aged, less than 1 year is rested. So we aged 3 years, that make our tequila, we call it Gran Añejo. That tequila is so fine, so good, so smooth, amigos, for its quality can be compared to the finest whiskey or the finest cognac. So this is not to be mixed, this is only for sipping. So this is the kind of bottle of tequila, amigos, I recommend you, you must have at least one bottle in your private bar away from everybody, only for you and your very close friends, to celebrate only very special occasions, like birthdays, anniversaries, weddings. Here in Mexico, we celebrate also divorces. So now, amigos, next we go to the tequila happy room. Okay, follow me, please, amigos. Tequila happy room. Here. Right? You're going to
taste some tequilas.
Oh. You need one little cup. You move a little bit over there. Yes, senor. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. All right.
Oh,
more? No, if you like, everybody, you can be by the wall.
Okay.
Yes. Everybody, here. Yes. Okay, first, amigos, you're going to taste the blanco. This is the blanco, the strongest. See, you can see the color, innocent color, but this is the strongest tequila. See, this is the base to make all the tequilas. So we're going to put some tequila in your glass. You want a little bit, you say poquito. You want a lot, you say mucho, or grande. Or you may say, quiero más tequila. That means I want more tequila. But don't drink it until everybody's ready. We're going to make a toast together, okay?
Okay.
So then you put in your glass. Okay. Sí. Poquito.
Poquito.
Muy, muy poquito.
Muy,
muy
poquito.
Muy poquito.
That's muy poquito.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Sí. Un poquito. Okay. Un poquito. Okay. Poquito. Poquito, señor. Okay. No problem. Okay. So everybody, please smell it first. Now inhale, exhale. That way you can get some air in your chest. So tequila doesn't burn you. Tequila doesn't make you cough. So many people in Mexico don't know about it. they have the big shot, they start coughing very hard. So now everybody say, through my lips.
Through my lips.
Around my gum.
Around my gum.
Watch our liver.
Watch our liver.
Here it comes.
Here it comes. Salute.
Okay. And that this is the Blanco tequila, the strongest. So this Blanco, we put on barrels, I told you, and we get this. We get the reposado. The amber color, as I told you, comes from the wood. This is the 11 months for shots. First one is for margaritas. Poquito?
Poquito.
Muy, muy poquito.
Muy poquito.
That's it, yeah.
See, this is the 11 months. Reposado. No, okay. All right. Poquito, see. Sí. Poquito, señor. Bien. So we buy a bottle. How long is the shelf life? How long? For tequila, it's whatever. For only flavors, you give the bottle closed, like for three or four years in storage. Once you open it, one year. Okay, once you open it, one year. Okay, so everybody repeat after me, smell it first, inhale. Exhale and say salud.
Salud.
All right, this is reposado, rested, 11 months. Okay. And this is a little bit smoother than the Blanco.
Yep.
This is smoother than the others. This is añejo, 3 years. The one I showed you for very special occasions. As I showed you, amigos, this is for sipping at home. I recommend you to use a sniffer glass, like cognac glass. So that way you can enjoy the aroma, the bouquet, and the barrel de tequila. Okay, so let's try the añejo. 3 years. Okay. Poquito.
Very little. Muy, muy poquito.
Muy poquito.
Yeah, thank you.
Grande.
Grande. Okay. Let me put grande here. This is 3 years. Poquito. Okay, this is 3 years.
No, cheers to getting started, huh?
Okay. Poquito. Poquito. Brandon here. the rest. There it is. Okay, the rest. Okay? So everybody smell it first. Inhale. Exhale. Now we're going to sip it. So we say, salud.
Salud.
I like the wood. The flavor is wood. Very good. Very good. Delicious.
Mm. Wow.
Delicioso. Yeah, that's the 3-year-old. This is the top shelf tequila. Okay? So far, we tasted tequilas, amigos. Now we're going to taste some flavors. For flavors, you keep the bottle closed, last for 3 or 4 years, as I told you before. Once you open it, last for 1 year. Besides tequila and natural flavors, we put agave syrup. We get that from the same plants. And that is recommended by the doctor for diabetic people because it has no cholesterol. And it's very low in sugar. Other companies, spice flavor, they put sugar cane. We put only agave syrup. It's a lot better. So we're going to start with the coffee chocolate. This is coffee chocolate. This one I recommend you for, you can put over your banana cream, banana split, in a milkshake, or on the Cheetos in the morning for breakfast.
Breakfast?
Yes. Coffee chocolate. Coffee chocolate.
I'll just taste hers.
Yes. Yeah. One more? No mas.
No.
Okay.
Okay.
There you go. The coffee chocolate.
Oh, it smells really good.
Yeah,
it
smells.
Cheers
really
to that.
Good.
Yeah. Smell it, Skippy.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
So everybody say, hasta la vista, baby.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Salud.
Salud.
Right. This is the coffee chocolate.
Okay.
Oh, I should have asked for the
yes,
whole thing.
That's very good.
That's good.
Really good.
Coffee.
That one's going home.
Agave syrup.
But I'll give it to Adriana so she can put in her luggage.
These amigos, next, this is the Mexican
amaretto. Oh, my goodness.
Tequila and almond. I recommend you this
amaretto.
For pumpkin, bananas, flambé, shrimps, mahi mahi, and stuffed turkey. This is, it has roasted almonds, tequila, and Damiana. Damiana is a herbal plant that grows in Sonora, Mexico. That is aphrodisiac for ladies.
Yep.
So we call this the Cuchi Cuchi bottle.
Okay, Cuchi Cuchi.
We call it tequila welcome to Puerto Viagra. But ladies, don't worry. The effect starts when you drink 2 full shots. I'm going to give you a little bit. So by the moment, no problem. Okay? By the moment, no problem. Okay, Cuchi Cuchi. Okay, Cuchi Cuchi.
Cuchi Cuchi.
Cuchi Cuchi.
the chikuchi, señor.
Oh, it smells good too, huh?
Yes.
I could do 2 full shots.
Right? Well, hey, we need a lot of coochie-coochie over here.
It sounded wrong,
huh?
See
what the deal is.
It sounded so bad.
So everybody say, amigos, repeat after me. We say, we are not a chicken.
We are not a chicken.
We are not shy.
We are not shy.
We all drink tequila.
And coochie-coochie tonight.
Salute.
Salute, amigos. How do you like it?
Good.
Oh, it's good. Okay. I was going home too.
Next, amigos, this is the orange mandarin. This is good for margaritas instead of the triple sec. Put this.
Oh.
And when you're going to cook chicken, turkey, or that, you marinate with this tequila for 2 or 3 hours, at least 1 hour, and it gets a better flavor. No matter how you cook it, it gets very good flavor with this tequila. Okay? Oh. Orange mandarin. Okay? Mandarina in Spanish.
Which mandarin? Okay. There you go.
Oh.
Oh my goodness.
Everybody repeat after me, amigos. Everybody say, hasta la vista, baby.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Salud.
Right.
Where's yours? You're dry.
Mm-hmm. I am on duty.
Oh.
I don't do when I work. I have a big shot.
That was
so
a test.
So far, we tasted tequilas and liqueurs. Now we're going to take some flavors. This is, creams. Creams flavor with tequila, too. This is vanilla cream. This is like eggnog.
Ooh.
This is good on your hot coffee or chill. Delicious, amigos. Very good. Chill, delicious. Okay, so let's finish this. Okay. There you go. This is vanilla.
Mucho.
Is this what you would call it, like similar to rompope?
Yes, similar to rompope.
Mucho.
Yeah, mucho, señor. Okay, there you go.
Perfecto.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Next.
It's like eggnog.
It's like eggnog, too. Okay. Very good. Vanilla and cream. Okay. So everybody say, amigos, one tequila, two tequila, three tequila, floor, salute, amigos, that's the vanilla flavor.
It's good.
Okay, how do you like that, good?
Mm.